Welcome. Today we will learn about structures and unions in C++. First of all, we will discuss structures in detail, its syntax and uses in C programming. Structures are basically composite data type that are used to store elements of different type under the single name. We have already discussed multiple times, we have to create a new project using console application, C++ project, type here project name and then click on OK. So repeating the steps, console application, C++ project, here will be the name of project, let's post structure and save the project in default directory. The default code of lines are already written in dev C++. Only we have to write using name space std. About this line, I have detailed discussion in complete tutorial of the C++ learning full course C++. So let's start by creating a structure using struct keyword. Its name is, let's suppose, employee. Structure contain multiple data items of different types under single name. It is also a continuous set of memory location on a side of arrays. Array is also continuous set of memory location, but under a single name and single type on similar items. It can contain distinct items of different types. Let's suppose int age, we say that char name, and its size may be 30, or we can also define it as string name, and let's suppose double salary. This structure contains three items of different type. We can clearly see here, I have to just define these items. This is the keyword. Each and every structure start from the keyword struct. This is the identifier for the structure by whom we will create variables of that structure. This is the first member, this is the second member, this is the third member of the employee structure. These members can be accessed by using the employee variable and member selection operator that we will do in main function. First member has the type of integer, second has string, and third has double type in this program. So let's start by creating variable from this employee structure. We are saying that emp1 emp2. We can also create array using this structure that we will discuss later on. Here I have to take input of employee 1. We say that enter age and take it in emp1 dot. Here is the list of attributes that are exist in employee structure already loaded into the dev C++. We say that the age, and similarly we can get age of second employee, enter age and m2.age. Before compilation we have to save this C++ file in the default directory. Okay, let's move to the explanation of these line of codes. This is the complete declaration and assignment statements and taking input and displaying output from the structures. The first line, line number, I can say that this is the line number 13, is declaring two structure type variables in main function. And in line number 14 and 15, we are going to get input in first employee, and line number 16 and 17 getting input of the age member in the employee structure. Similarly, we can type here to display output on the screen. We say that age of first employee, we have to display here m1.age. This is the much more simple. The simple syntax of the structure and the declaration and assignment of the structure is as follows. So let's compile it. The code is compiled successfully. We say that first employee age is 30 and second one is 45. It is displaying the age of first employee. As we have written in the C++ statement, we have to display the age of first employee, that is 30. We can also display the age of second employee, just we have to change the, or we can also display the name of second employee dot name. This will the garbage value. First of all, we have to take the name of second employee. We can also use assignment statement to assign the value to the structure members. The dots symbol is called member selection operator in C++. This is used to get the members of the structure type variables or class type objects. We say that name is equal to ABC, etc. Here name will be the print of the second employee. This is getting age. We can see here clearly the name of second employee is ABC. There is a message different in the code. Here we will have to write second employee. Okay. This is the basically declaration and assignments and structure of the struct keyword and structures in C++. We can also define or declare variable here after the immediate after the definition of the structure. Here we can also define a list of variable. We can provide here list of variables, structure variables of similar type. Theek? Here we have to take input. Let's suppose we say that cout enter first employee ID. We say here cin. We have to check either these variables that are declared after the definition of the structure are accessible in main function. So let type here m1 dot. This is successfully accessible. No, we have not written any kind of ID. We are going to age, and secondly we are going to print this age of employee. What will the age of employee? M1 dot age, whatever we will type on the time of execution. Okay, well, let's suppose I am typing here 67. We can see here variables of the structure can also be declared after immediate definition of the structure. This is a method we can do it. Here is one more thing that I want to share with you, that we can also define structure as the user defined type using type def is a keyword. We say that type def, this will make it imply structure as the user defined type. We say here emp. Two alternatives are used to define the structure, and after definition of the structure we can also provide the list of structure variable, or we can define it as user defined data type. This is user defined data type. Now what will IE EMP? EMP is the user defined data type. Let's try to create structure type variables using EMP. We say that m1, similarly m2, m1 dot name is equal to xyz, cout m1 dot name seed it in output. We can see here this is also a valid method for creating variables of the structure using type def, user defined type of the structure. We can also create arrays of the structure type variables. Similarly as the standard input or data types, we can also create the array of structure type, user defined data type. We say that amp 10. What will be the method to access the elements and data members of this amp 1 or amp 2, etc.? We say that amp, we have first of all to get the index of the employee. Let's suppose this will from 0 to 9 dot its member. We say that name is equal to hi, and then we are going to print amp 0 dot name. This will print on the screen first element of the amp, and this is going to print on the screen. What is going on in this syntax? I have to clearly elaborate this syntax and line of codes. Here is the struct keyword is used and the identifier of the structure is specified here. This is the opening and closing delimiters, or we can say that body of the structure. And here goes the first attribute, second attribute, or data member of the structure. Each and every data member of the structure has different type. It may be a similar or different. It is not compulsory to specify similar or specify different data types for each and every individual data items in the structure. After doing this, we can use this user defined data type in main function to define the user defined data type structure variables. We are creating here array of this structure type definition or data type. Array of 10 elements is created here, and accessing the first element attribute name, specifying its value as high and printing on it on the screen. There was the two concept of basic structure definition, structure data type, and array of the structure. We can also create structures of the structure. What is the concept of structure of structure? In this concept, one structure may contain data items as the structure of other type. We say that industry. This is the other structure, industry. Here we say int industry ID or particular, and second one is employee, or we can say that EMP, employee 100. What it means? It means that industry structure, whenever variable from industry structure will created, it has two members. One is its ID and other is the list of employees, and each and every employee will contain three attributes. That will be the age, name, and salary. Let's try to create this variable of industry type. We say that industry, IND industry. How we can access the industry attribute dot ID? We say here industry dot ID is equal to 10. Okay, compile it. The problem is that we have to place semicolon after the structure. We say here industry IND dot ID is equal to 100. Let's suppose 100. IND dot employee. Here we will have to specify which employee. First employee dot, here is also a list of age or name or other values or data members. We can compile it again. A successful compilation is completed. We will not go through each and every individual elements to how to print, how to use cout, because we are covering just the basic concept of the structure that will be helpful in later on. This is the structure, and now we are going to discuss what is meant by union, what is its purpose, and how we can define union. To understand the union and to have clear vision, what is the difference between union and structure? Union and structure have some kind of similarities, as structure and arrays has some kind of similarities. Similarly, union and structure has some kind of similarities. What is the similar thing in union and structure? Structure is a continuous set of memory location of different data types, of different members, of different member types, and union is also a continuous set of memory location of different member or different data types, but different lies here. Union is used where we are space conscious. So let's first of all define a union, then we will discuss it in detail. Let's suppose we say that employee, this is the structure of union for creating or defining the union. This is much more similar, except the union keyword used in structure. First of all, we are creating its data members. Let's suppose we say that int a char ch and double salary. Okay, now this union contains three data members, first of type int, second of type character, third of type salary. For clear demonstration, I have to write down, it takes 1 byte in memory, it takes 4 byte in memory, it takes 1 byte, and double will take 8 byte in memory. The size of double data type is 8 byte. Whenever union is declared or defined, compiler pick the maximum size of data member and other size are required to accommodate in this memory location. Again, I have to explain this concept by using the size of operator that will clear demonstrate how union works. This is the union definition. Here we have first data member of integer type whose size occupied in memory is 4 byte. Second is character type whose size is 1 byte. Third one is the of double type whose size is 8 byte. In structure, if we say in structure the same definition, then this structure will occupy 13 byte in memory. If we write down union in the same data members or elements, it will occupy only 8 byte in memory. As I have started discuss in the start of the union session, that union is used where we are space conscious, because it only occupies the maximum data member space in the memory. So let's check it in the practical demonstration. We are going to create employee emp, one variable of union type. We say that cout size of emp 1. Using the size of operator, we can identify how many bytes are occupied in memory using this variable. Size of emp 1, and here will be the semicolon. Okay, save it, compile it. As we have discussed, this will take 8 bytes in memory. emp 1 is confusing with the space or memory size. Now it is getting 8 byte in memory. What will happen if we remove the double from the data member of the union? Now it will take only 4 bytes in memory, because the maximum size of the data member is 4. Now one experiment is more for this type of union. We say that double percentage, what will happen now? It contains percentage variable, salary variable, two are of 8 bytes, one is of 1 byte, and one is of 4 byte. Now in that situation, employee variable of this union will take only 8 byte, because the maximum storage is the 8 byte, so that it will take only 8 byte in the memory to save the entire values of this union. In case of structure, if we say that the similar case in structure, then structure will take 8, 16, 17 and 21 byte in memory. This is the basic difference between structures and union in C++. So let's check it, how many byte it will occupy. It is now also occupying 8 byte in memory. There is also a type of union in C++ that is called anonymous union. Anonymous union does not specify the identifier or name of the union. It only contains data members or the elements to whom we want to save the values. Further, the remaining actions of input, output, creating arrays, passing it to the function in union and structure are similar. We can also define the union as the type def we have written before in structure and specify here emp or any other identifier, valid identifier. On the other hand, we can also specify here list of union variables separated by comma. All entire things are similar in case of union and structure. Aside this, union take minimum space for the storage and manipulation, but the shortcoming of union is that each and every individual, because each and every individual is not taking its own private memory, so that the resultant result of this union or attribute may be differ as we saved before. So let's start by using the example. We say that emp1 dot, we are going to save in data member A is equal to 10. If we see out emp1 dot A, it will display 10 on the screen because we have saved it 10 on the screen. If we say that in later on A percentage is equal to 2.5, and notice here the difference between employee and structure. Here we can notice the major difference between employee and structure. We have saved in attribute A 10, and after this we save attribute percentage 2.5. Now we are printing the value of A. As we have discussed, union use shared memory of maximum size so that the value of A will be overwrite to 0. Now it is accessing A as 0 because A is not available. If we write here percentage will be available here as the 2.5. we can clearly see here. We can also define union in structures declaration and structure in union declaration. These are the other aspect we have tried in our home. So that's so nice of you in today's discussion of structure and union and how these structure and union works. Thank you.